little bit of the contest here in the men's division between Cable Beach and Luma, and as we expected, it's fast-paced action onto the outer side as we go inside the forward 50. A nice quick kick away there by Farrah, doesn't find the target, or they do. This is a really good start here by Peninsula. So nice quick start. And here is this man, Reece Agenor. He had a great game last week. Started off a bullet a gate last week. Kicked the first goal of the game and may do it again as well. The number 20 for Peninsula Bombers. Comes in with the bright boots. Don't mind the look of Reece. And a lovely kick to start things off. Just a behind. The wind is playing havoc. Joining commentary now for this game, Tom Chapman joins us. Good morning, Tom. Thanks for joining us today. Good
morning, Ed. Thanks for having me in.
Look, there's plenty going on, of course, here today. Mainly the wind is wreaking havoc.
Yeah, it is. And look, we'll see which team can capitalise on that or deal with it as best they can. See that kick come out to the back pocket.
So Willie Fong off the half back line. Moves along the broadcast wind. That's coming straight to you, Tom. You reach out and touch it. It's going to hit my bike.
About all the stats I'll get. But there's the wind that you can see early on. That's just drifted 5 metres straight out of bounds there, Ed. And you know, wasn't that bad off the boot. But, yeah, which team can get a hold of that wind or harness it best will have a big factor here.
Simcox setting things up. Brett Dan looking for options, chips it across, doesn't find the target. He does so in the end. It's Michael Jakira. Nice deliberate build-up. Willie Farrah in a bit of bother there as they move it on forward again. Changed his number from 19 to 23 this week. And away go Cable Beach. Long penetrating kick in the attacking direction of Holman. And a good strong mark taken there by Ronan Maher, I should say.
A nice transition through the middle there by Cable Beach. Took on the kick and really delivered it, and look, it really opened up the Bombers there as they cut through the middle, and see how the shot at goal pans out for them.
So Ronan to put some damage on the scoreboard here early for Cable Beach. How will he judge the wind? Look at it hold up ever so slightly and through for a behind. So one behind each in the early stages of this one. Just been going 2-3 minutes. And they're moving the ball quickly. Good effort, playing on quickly. Trying to get the ball away there is Jaden Howard. Hand slung to the ground and we'll get the free kick. Fong marking it. Nice little lead up kick. Can he hit the target? No, bowls everyone over. Keeping it in play. Lovely work there by Daniel Cox. Chips it across. Here come Cable Beach again. Look at the big bodies just bustling their way through the middle of the ground. Horseman. High up and under kick. Up, up, hey. Up and away. What a wonderful mark.
No problems, Jason.
Whoa, way. Did we like that one? Oh, wow. We're still coming down that. Edwin McGinty reached for the stars and got the sun. Wow, wee, Fong in the back and probably get a free kick of it. Still coming down from that. That was sensational.
No problems at all there, judging the wind it seems from McGinty. He just got up there and the only issue was if he was blown away.
Whew. One of the best marks you'll see in any league for that matter. As Willie Fong will line up. Wind's just died down, so he may make the most of this opportunity in front of the big sticks. Good looking kick, bending too far. Through for another behind.
Beach have been pretty solid here, locking it in there, attacking 50. Comes out now, the release, using the wind.
And over the boundary line again. So, nice start here by both sides. Good pace of the game early on. The wind already wreaking havoc with the goal kicking. This will be interesting to see how the players adjust. Field kicking looks all right. Goal kicking, an issue early on. Fong trying to bust his way through a Willie Farrow tackle. It doesn't end up happening. Another quick handball away. Peninsula under pressure. Oh, lovely footwork there by Din Hunter, the skipper. He kicks a wobbly kick up forward. Centre wing working really hard is Pomora. Goes Solly. Can he pick it up with the blue suede shoes? Running faster than the ball. Then he gets tunnelled in the process. It's hemmed up on the boundary line. Ball just skedaddling left, right and centre. And all tied up, you would think. The umpire's going to come in and ball it up. Wow-wee, helter-kelter stuff. And Daniel Cox, I don't know about that hairstyle, but I like any hair, really. It's fluffy. Willie Farrow up in the ruck. Seen that many times for his days in the NT Thunder. Under pressure, shaking that tackle easily. There was Tyrone Cox. He moves into the middle of the ground, and now it's going backwards to go forwards. It's going the wrong way, Coxie. And now they centre on the ball. Cable Beach. Beachy's coming left, right, and everywhere in the middle of the ground. Nelson on the bottom of this one. And Pingvall on the ball. Couldn't get rid of it. And they're going to play on quickly here, Cable. No, slowing things up. On to centre wing, out towards the high school they go. The Beaches in control, or so they seem, in a beautiful lead-up mark on the outer side. And Cable Beach, again, more lead starting to make their way forward again.
It's a penetrating kick by you. And he's
through for a goal. Lovely work, wasn't it? Fantastic effort there by Maher in the end. First major on the board. 1-2-8 to one behind. It's Cable Beach leading just here at Haynes Oval today. At Calshaw and Tom Chapman in commentary.
Yeah, it's pretty hot around the contest there, and I think the only chances that they've had, really, they've capitalised on Cable Beach with getting that transition, switching it through the middle, and it, you see there, three good kicks, and they've put a goal through.
It's back in the middle of the ground. Terence Cox doing the work. Tap down again. Here they go. And away they move through Cox. That's Tyrone. Moving up forward, but Cable Beach have got other things on their minds. They're looking to hem it in. Tyrese again, going forward again. Nice work, bombing it on forward, but Cable Beach, slow and steady, wins the race in this one. Heading out to Daniel Cox. Can't miss him with the pill. Pops it up, and staying to lead in nicely. William Hunter, under pressure, shakes a tackle. Play on advantage, needs to hit the target. Good mark. Good strong mark and leadership there by Elijah Howard. Slowing things up. Wind starts the build. Howard chips it across over the head there of Bim Barker. And a nice mark taken there by Aaron Cox. So Cox looking for options. Over the head there of Jakira. Just patiently pacing their game, Peninsula. Nearly in the back there. They play on quickly nonetheless. Good work there. Hemmed up on the boundary line was Hunter. Under pressure again is Cox. He gets it out. Walking for Jaden Howard, who was brilliant last week. Trying to maintain control here at Cable Beach. They're under pressure. Contested footy at its best now. Pomora, Solomon that is. Turnover. And it's past the parcel footy in the middle of the ground. Cable Beach under pressure. The goal kicker in Maher. High up and under kick. Onto centre wing they go. And here comes Jakara. High up and under kick onto centre wing again. Dangerous kicks in this sort of breezy weather. Jakara's going to get it again. He overran it. Peninsula under pressure. Beachy's everywhere as we speak. No one can get a handle on the pill on the outer side near the high school, and it will be a ball up.
Free kick there to Beach. They're using it well on that high school side there.
Playing on quickly again. D'Antoni looking for options. Heading in the Maher direction. What can they find? Oh, it may roll all the way. No, going across the ground. Struggling to control it is the big marker in McGinty. Maybe tripped. He played on quickly. Twists around. Pops it in the Maher direction. May bounce. Trapped on the ground. Trying to get a goal. Maher snaps over his body. Bang, goal!
Just locked it in there. Locked it in there, the Beach, and really struggling to get it out when it gets squashed down in that forward 50. The Bombers we see again Cable Beach using the high school side there into the breeze, but managing to penetrate it with a few good kicks, and it's opening up the Bombers at this stage.
2-2-14 to one behind, and lovely work there by Cable Beach, really working hard today to get that penetration on through, and the way that they're using the ball in the lead up forwards as well. So back in the middle of the ground, been going 10 minutes in this first quarter. WKFL action at its best here at Haynes Oval today. Cable Beach and the Peninsula Bombers. And a free kick going to Tyrone Cox. So Cox, long kick inside the forward 50, another high marking attempt at the fall of it. Twisting and turning, free kick, no, advantage paid. And away they go onto the outer side. Cox again, back from whence it came. High looking kick, and it's through for a behind.
Great effort there from distance. Used the wind to just blow it back across and didn't quite sneak it through, caught the post, and just the minor again for the Bombers.
So we might struggle to see point-to-point goal kicking today. One end to the other. Bring it in is Joe Dan in the back line. Saw Annie doing some great work with the women's side earlier, and Catherine as well. Nice high kick. Putting that up in the night sky. Dion Parryman had to work hard for that. Plenty of people around him to spoil it, and goes out of bounds. Saw Parryman actually at the markets on the way through. Couldn't miss the afro.
It's quite prominent out there.
Looking good in the Cable Beach gear, just swanning around. Didn't get himself a Lusker, just popping there, getting a coffee, and off to the footy he was. Tap down there again. Wonderful work there by Daniel Cox to try and get himself out of trouble. But in the end, got themselves in trouble. And here comes Jaden Howard. Set things up brilliantly last week. But again, Cable Beach just snicking out the mitts. Cox along the line. Up, up. And down he comes, Edward again. Edward McGinty taking mark of the year already this year. It's going to be hard to beat, Tom.
Gee, really got up there on that. And love to see the replay later on.
So away they go, settling things up. Big bodies crashing. Brad Horseman there setting this play up in the Maher direction. Bit far away from
big
goal,
tackle.
But wasn't that a brilliant tackle?
Tackling's been
Elijah Howard. Wow.
Both clubs really putting on the pressure here, so it's who can handle the heat.
Maher again under pressure. He's gone to ground here. Can he get some help here in that forward line? Under siege. Bombers everywhere. Peninsula looking to clear. Calling for it wide. There is Jakira.
Got the extra man here. See if they can get a bit
great
of
support
run.
Offered there by Din Hunter. Oh, a bit lazy there, Willie.
Whoa, went for the bump when he could have tackled.
Twisting and turning. Howard.
Jeez.
Didn't have the ball. They're going in hard, and Howard's down at the moment. He's feeling the pinch. Fong looking for a kick. Does it. Great patience and poise here by Cable Beach to set things up. Yu into the middle of the ground. This is a really nice setup here by Cable Beach. Finding Maher again.
Oh, great.
What a great lead out. That reminds me of Jason Dunstall back in the heyday in the VFL.
Almost swallowed it, didn't he? Whew. Again, that transition through the middle, two good kicks, and they're in the 50 having a shot at goal lead. I think that's Cable Beach's plan to open up the Bombers here.
So Maher chips it across. I think he's winded himself there as well. Under pressure, trying to move it on forward. Kiefer Yu trying to offer something as well. That's seen over the boundary line deep in the forward pocket. And it will be balled up. Or thrown up, I should say. Deep in the forward pocket for Cable Beach. Trying to get it out. They do so. Hemmed in on the boundary. And straight across the face of goal.
Didn't have much chance curling that back against the wind there, Ed, but tough kick, and they'll try and lock it in here, Cable Beach, and Bombers will hope to squeeze it out and put it down the other end of it.
So ball will be thrown up in the other forward pocket there that time. Tap down there by D'Antoni. Looking for something out of nothing here at Cable Beach, but Peninsula through Corpus and Cox. Nice work there by Horseman to slow things up. But Willie Farrow for the Bombers. Torpedoes it forward. What a great mark. But it's been called back and Horseman's going to take the free kick.
Really locking the ball in here, Cable Beach, in their forward half. Set up well behind the play and it's tough for the Bombers to get the ball out.
Nice kick up goes Eddie again and a great mark. What hands he has. Edward McGinty snaps it across. Whoa, where is that going? Look at the wind. Take that away. Courage personified underneath that one. Looking for options. In the area there, of course, was Severia Corpus, but now it's on centre wing.
Cable Beach again set up well behind the play and they're just driving it back in. Hugh takes the mark, probably 45 out straight in front.
But where will it go, Tom? That's the question. We saw it in a women's game that it was just falling in the goal square every single time. It's a bit of a force field. Look at it hold up. Needs all his legs, but it's straight through the middle.
Yeah, for you, made no mistake there. He's just drilled it over the umpire's hat. Second goal there. Cable Beach. I think Bombers really need to look at a way to break through this press that Cable Beach have got on, Ed, because they're getting the ball locked in their defensive half and finding it hard to get through. Bit of dash, I think, we might see. Bit of a rev after the from the coach at quarter time.
3-2-20 to two behinds. That's been the story thus far today in this encounter. 16 minutes gone in this first quarter. WKFL windy footy action here at Haynes Oval today. Ed Cowlisher and Tom Chapman in commentary with you. Nice tap down, but can they get the clearance? They do so. Here comes Cable Beach again. Another penetrating kick. Maher on the lead. Geez, doesn't he lead well? Reads the play so brilliantly, does Romar. And he'll line up for his third opportunity at a major today. Already got two next to his name. And the wind just dies down. Does he rush his routine? Oh, there it is again. So Romar, the number 31 for Cable Beach. Nice looking kick. Look at it hold up in the breeze. Pushes across and through for a behind. 3-3-21, plays two behinds.
Bombers looking to break out of their defensive 50 here. It's they're bunched in the middle. We might see a different play or a bit of a spread, but it's been tough going for them so far getting it out of there.
Tyson Cox onto the outer side, looking for Jalen Howard. Instead finds Michael Jaquin. Slow build up here, Cable Beach, another chance just outside the forward 50. On the left they go, and a beautiful mark and another opportunity at the big sticks. Elijah Howard this time. Again, 25 metres out, Tom.
Yeah,
what are your odds?
Slightly favourable inside, as we've heard many times before, inside left goalpost is where you'd want to do it, but probably inside left point post, given the gale we've got here at the moment, he's facing Howard.
Really blowy conditions today. 25 to 30 k's easterly direction. What will Elijah do? He'll pop it straight through the middle. It won't bother the big fella. And another major on the board. That's the fourth for Cable. 4-3, 27 to two behinds. And now starting to break away from Peninsula.
Yeah, Bombers need to work on a way to break it out of that back half even. Probably even the defensive 50 for them, because Beach is set up really well and they're just locking it in there. Really hard to get a good clean breakaway for the Bombers, but centre bounce, let's hope they can push it forward and take advantage of the six up there.
It's back in the middle we wander. 25 point lead, Cable Beach lead. Tap down again, all hemmed up and they'll do it again. Only a minute to go in this first quarter, 19 minutes ticked over. Looking for the clearance, desperate for it. Howard gets it over the top. Harjanor trying to do something with it. But away go Cable Beach. And now they've got a paddock to play with Stephen Howard. He goes inboard. Over the top. Peninsula misread it.
Oh, well picked up.
Elijah Howard tried to pick it up. Dean Hunter, can he settle things down for Peninsula? Shakes one tackle. Oh, taken high after the kick. And out of bounds on the full. Umpire missed that one completely.
Wind might have blown his vision a bit off.
That's a good excuse.
The Bombers. The force pressure, kick's gone out of bounds right through the interchange gates there.
Only seconds left in this first quarter. Cable Beach look to move it forward. Is there another chance? Cox goes up. Horseman, hand passes to no one in particular. He's going to go back for it. Seen over the boundary line. May get a free kick. Whoa! That was late. And we might have something going on here. That was not good. They're saying howdy do. That was very late, right in front of us. And there's a meeting of players saying g'day to one another.
Just testing.
Lazy footy here from Peninsula. And they're going to say g'day to one another.
Look more than clumsy right in front of us, Ed. And maybe that's a spark for the Bombers there.
Well, it was really not needed. And that's just frustration, it looks like, as well. At scoreline, a quarter time, 4-3-27 two behinds. It is Cable Beach leading Peninsula here at Haynes Oval today. Ed Cowlishaw and Tom Chapman in commentary. Your goal kickers for today thus far, Roe Mars kicked two, Elijah Howard with one, and Kefa Yu also has kicked a major as well. Great to have your company wherever you are listening in, I should say, via the tube or, of course, on the old wireless as well. We'll take a short break and we'll be back with the second quarter. Cox loses a handle on it as well. The poise is completely out of it in the next couple of minutes, I feel. Horseman, hand passes over the top. Nice long kick, and Eddie's there again.
Just good pressure there. Follow-up repeat pressure there by Cable Beach, and they forced the turnover, forced it back in, and it's landed there in,
Ed McGinty.
In the arms of Ed McGinty.
Took a mark of the year contender. Oh, we give it to him now, I think. Beautiful-looking kick off the boot. Can he scrape it through? And again, Cable Beach struggling with the posters.
We've had a few posters over the games today, haven't we?
We did.
Second one here, and we're just in the second quarter, and there's a few in the ladies' game earlier.
Yes, four in the ladies' game registered. 4-4-28 to two behinds as Peninsula moving into the middle of the ground. Parryman in the back.
Clear one
there. Free kick.
He's taken the advantage on, and they've opened it up this way, the Bombers.
This could be a good chance for them to get their first on the board. They play on quickly through Courtney Cox.
Yeah,
another high marking. We're seeing everything today. Play on quickly. Snap off the boot. Out of bounds on the full.
Just got pushed as he was taking the kick there. Might have been stiff not to get one, but ball's floated out. And
high flying marking coming left, right and centre today, which is great to see. Frequent fly points up for grabs.
It's a good day for Kites, and I think the players are taking that on themselves.
Nathan Levin kicks it out. Slow build-up out of defence. Good mark there by Jordan King on the outer side. Plays on quickly. Now onto the half-forward line. And away they go through Horseman. Another penetrating kick. This is the point-to-point kicking we were talking about earlier.
Well,
they play on quickly.
Up.
Can it bounce, 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 bounce?
It's rolled straight
on
through
for a goal.
It's end-to-end there from Cable Beach. Just field kicking is really setting them up well, Ed. I think they're just hitting those targets and, as you said, penetrating it is. Through the wind, they're keeping it low. And see, it's nice football that they've
What a classy finish by Ma. He's got three. Unbelievable. And just has that forward now, doesn't he? Can mark and lead on the chest. And then, of course, just keeps his feet at the right times and created something out of nothing.
Oh, the crumb was sensational. He just picked it up. Quick look where the goals were, threw it on the boot, and even from here it didn't look like missing, Ed. Rolled it through nicely.
5-4-34 to two behinds. It's Cable Beach in control. Cox, hand passes over the top, and away they go again through Jordan King. And a nice lead out mark. And guess who?
It's Kefa Yu.
Had some waffle experience. Handy player and trusts himself from this distance and even against the wind. He's going to use it. Look at the mileage on that. Straight over the umpire's head for a behind.
Just didn't swing it back around enough. The wind almost died off a touch there in the breeze, unfortunately, for him. But gives the Bombers a chance here to try and another crack to get out of their defensive 50.
And a chance for a seven-point play, as Dennis Cometti would say. So out of the back line we go. peninsula. Looking for options. Marching through the ground was Joe Dan. Thought he had something to talk about. Instead, Jordan King mobs up for Cable Beach.
Train goes to the station on that one.
Goes to inwards. This time finds Stephen Howard.
Oh, good smother there.
In the middle of the ground again they go. Twisting and turning their way out of trouble. Horseman. Geez, he's been good at centre half forward today. Holding the ball. Quick on it, the umpires. No dilly-dallying today, gentlemen.
Bombers have looked a lot more settled in their defence right now. Start of the second quarter.
Willie Farrer. Been held without it. Used to play with the Southern Districts in the Territory in the NT Thunder as well. Speaking of high flyers, he was one of the best in his younger days. Probably still got it as well, Willie, I reckon. Up we go again. No, good, solid mark. Taken there in defence. And Cable Beach will look to work themselves out of it. No. Howard. He was brilliant in the start last week against the Tigers. What can he do now?
Lining up for the shot. Be a tough kick. Pushing through the breeze, but he reckons he's got the distance.
Oh, he's pushed it on forward. Might get a mark out of it. Nearly had it. Two bites of the cherry. Harjanor under pressure. Taken without it. Trying to get control of it at the bottom of this one. Play a game of twister. And the umpire will come up and spin the wheel again.
Good forward pressure there by the Bombers to lock it in.
Ball goes up. Carryman wins the tap, but not the clearance. But here comes Cox. Needs to be a good kick for Horseman. He's under pressure. Three Bombers with him. Plays on quickly. Beat all of them. How are they getting out of trouble here? Cable Beach sidestepping left, right and centre. Up goes Eddie. Another one. Gosh, he's got a great pair of hands. Touched off the boot, was it? Play on quickly. Moves it on McGinty. Looking for another target. Great courage.
Oh, and goes around it.
You. Advantage or not advantage? What are we going with, umpire?
Umpire's
no, 50 metres.
Called him 50. It was a courageous mark there running back with the flight, Ed.
So you is going to take it. Bit of chatter going on as well. Lucky to get that, I would have thought.
Yeah, the 50. I don't know if the 50 was there, but he's popped it through. I mean, you can see the Bombers are really trying to... They're searching for a spark here. They need something. Putting a bit of physicality into it, which, you know, not a bad thing, but... Just want to control that aggression and make the most of it.
6-5-41 to two behinds. And a goal there to Kiefer Yu. That's another one for him. And, well, as we see that, I mean, it's sort of a goal out of nothing in a lot of ways. They had the build-up right.
Yeah, it took a good mark, though. I mean, you've got to pay that. Running back with the flight, he had eyes only for the ball. It's a great part of footy to see that happen. And
there is that real intimidation factor with Cable Beach. And I feel as though Peninsula might be getting intimidated out of this game and the way that they're going about it, letting their frustrations play out, playing the man, not the ball. And again, another free kick being given away. This time, going to Jordan King.
Yeah, they've been bringing the pressure, but just need to control that and make the most of that effort that they're putting in, I think, here, Bombers.
Controlled aggression, I believe it's called, and a good mark taken there by Maher again.
Because we're just seeing, again, we're here... Cable Beach got the mark inside 50, and look, they're making the most of it already, six goals. It's something that Bombers really want to address there. Keep a hold of the ball, maybe a bit more possession even.
So Ma looking for his fourth of the day. He will use the breeze on this one. We saw what you did before. Already got three to his name today. Can he kick a fourth? Look at that go. High up and under, goes across the face of goal. Eddie McGinty underneath it, but a mark has been taken. At the fall of it, and it's Horseman.
It was a good snatch there. He's among three Bombers, and he just managed to pluck it. The long arms came out, but this would be a really tough kick across the goals into the weed.
Well, I'll tell you what. He's happy with it.
Made a mockery of me. He's just walked around and sailed that through, Ed.
Great goal there by Nathaniel Hale.
Don't know if it was deliberate, but he kept a bit of the spin off the ball on the drop punt, and it seems to have paid off there quite nicely.
Might need to spread the message through the rest of the squad. 7-5-47 to two behinds. So Cable Beach in complete control.
You can see the stand mark there. Just, you know, the guy on the mark was right next to the point post, but being able to run around, he just casually slotted it. It was a great result for the Cable Beach.
So ball back in the middle. This game really starting to get away from Peninsula as away go Cable Beach again, and the training run continues for them. Jackson Leach bombs it on forward. Here's Horseman off one step. Bang! There they go.
I'll get around him for that one. Bustled the tackle. There was a bit of the package in that one, I think, Ed. Just kind of shrugged the shoulders, shrugged the hips, and one step, 45 out. Drilled it home.
Brad Horseman off one leg. A powerful man he is. He gets his first major of the day.
Gets rewarded with a spell on the bench for that too.
Well, deserved it, but what a powerful kick it was. 8-5, 53. The game completely getting out of control. As the ball back in the middle, 6-6-6, free kick.
Behind the play here.
Just making sure that everyone's got their 6-6-6s going. Umpires on the ball with that. Carriman goes up again. Tap down, Peninsula, can they get a clearance? This time might be a possibility through Cox. Up and under another forward 50 entry for them, but they can't find their target, and away go Cable Beach again, getting themselves out of trouble. Good work there by Joe Dan. He's been great today in defence.
Yeah, and they're controlling the ball really well on that high school side. They almost like they own it out there, Cable Beach.
Methodical in the way they're going about it as Dan gets the ball again in the middle of the ground. Misses everyone. Under pressure is Jaden Howard. Twisting is turning his way out of trouble, but unfortunately to no avail, and got pinged for holding the ball.
Forward pressure is a great tackle. Just took his arm out and really stuck there when you've only got one finger or two on the ball.
So Edward McKinty has seen Horseman kick a goal from here. You kick a goal from here. Getting advice from Cox as well. What can he do? He goes bang. Oh, it's a helicopter kick into the forwards. Goal square, and away they go, trying to clear.
Three bounces out of the square.
Lovely work, chipping across.
It's a well-weighted kick.
And doesn't get it in the end. And away they go again, heading there for Silas Cox. Cardinal wanted to play on quickly.
He has paid advantage here.
Advantage, jeez, late advantage call. They lose it in the end. Peninsula under pressure. Cox, hand passes over the top, looking there for Dajuan. May get it again, and they finally find a target, and a nice mark taken there by Solomon Pomora. Pomora, high up and under kick, one versus three.
Oi.
Doesn't get the opportunity, no one in support really.
Good follow-up pressure here by the Bombers. They're locking the ball in, not letting Cable Beach get out with it. They've earned the ball up there, just forward pocket, see if they can snag their first one here.
So Barb Dutchwin's just going up for everything up in the forward line there for Peninsula. Tapped across. Dan at the fall of this. Under pressure. And away they go onto the outer side through Jordan King.
Really enjoying that high school side, aren't they, Cable Beach? Taking a mark here again. Another mark. Good mark by Dan.
Dantwan. Nice kick. And Mar again. Within range, as we know. But will he look for the team first approach? Looking for options, chips it across. And nice, easy stuff there by Cable Beach. Just to slow things up a little bit. And a good mark taken there by Yu. So Yu plays on quickly. And just getting tired here, Peninsula, or lazy, one or the other. Elijah Howard now, closer in, better angle, 30 metres out. And the breeze will help him as well. He's already kicked one major today.
Foot skills there by Cable Beach, just pushing the ball. That's six kicks there that they just taken uncontested marks from. Shot a goal here.
So you, or Howard I should say. And it's through for a behind. So all the momentum with Cable Beach, 8-6, 54.
Yeah, look, Cable Beach are really pushing it through that side with the high school side with those sharp kicks, and Bombers have got to address that, otherwise really this game's just going to run away from them, I think, Ed.
13 minutes gone, 8-6-54 to two behinds. Peninsula looking for something creative. We know they can do special things. Slowing things up, methodical approach. Tyson Cox looking for opportunities.
Arginor's got his hands up on the outer wing here.
And kicks it to no one in particular, and Joe Dan looks like he's going to swoop on it. Great tackling pressure, slung to the ground, and we'll get the free kick for it as well. Hard ground here at Haynes. Dry season footy. Wind is blowing out towards the cricket nets we go. Hand pass over the top, umpire, no advantage. Probably had it, Cable Beach. And a free kick coming back.
Like it's Seb Corpus, I think, taking the kick here. Lining up for the shot. Seems confident. He's got a bit of wind over his shoulder. puts this right goalpost.
I think they're all trying to outdo each other from outside 50 with the wind that's keeping him company. Whoa, up goes Eddie again. Jump. Misjudges at that time. Hasn't done that too often. He's going to end up with it, get a trip, and we'll get a free kick for his troubles.
I think he's paid against him. He's caught him dropping the ball there.
Really?
He almost dropped his pants, the tackler there. It was that low. It slid down around his ankles, but he's pinged him.
Cox chips it across.
Flirting with danger here, the Bombers.
Oh, big time, are they ever, as they play on quickly. Cox again, chips across. Nice work, and Carriman will fall into the hole. Drops what he probably really should have taken, and a free kick's given away to Jaden Howard. So Howard wants to play on quickly. Had a haircut during the week. Horseman, under pressure, plays on quickly. Dan, lovely work there by Cable Beach. Moving it inside 50, they go now. Looking for a mark. Where's Mar, the goal kicker?
Oh,
but it's Eddie that's at the fall of it. Does he get a free kick? He does for his troubles.
Had his name all over it, that one, Ed. Forced the offence there because he was going to jump on his shoulders and the defender just raked him back down to earth. Probably the only way you can stop him there. Camped underneath it and don't think you have any problems putting this one through from just top of the goal square.
So Eddie McKinty lines it up. Nice, easy goal. And another one on the board. 9-6, 60 to 2 behinds. As the big full forward, you know, Romar comes off for a break.
Cable Beach putting on a bit of a clinic here, it seems, Ed. They're getting the ball forward straight out of the centre. They're really dominating that centre clearance. And then once the ball's up there, there's like a brick wall built across the halfway line pretty much. Bombers are struggling to break through, and that's just going to happen. They're getting the ball in, good kicks. It's only a matter of time before they make those count and score the majors.
Well, it's by a matter of how far. And the scary thing is we're only in the second quarter. 9-6, 60 to 2 behinds. 16 minutes about to tick over. Cox under pressure. May end up with it. But Peninsula may get a centre clearance here. One bounce. Probably could take another if he wanted to. Two. Lovely work here, Din Hunter. Chips it across. Beautiful play, Bombers.
That's what they need, the Bombers there. Just got the centre clearance. Got a bit of space there moving forward in here. Delivered well into the 50. Presented up there by Darwin. Look, he'll take his shot here. He's probably feeling confident. He's 35 out, 40 when he kicks it, but straight in front.
Well, hopefully he doesn't play on from it. Tend to do that. Skippity skip, hoppity hop. Boston goes in. And the first major on the board for Peninsula. And that's how they do it. All set up by Din Hunter. 1-2-8. First major on the board. In the second quarter, it comes to 9-6-60. And maybe life has been breathed into this game ever so slightly for the Bombers.
Well, there's definitely a key in there, I think, for the Bombers on what they need to do. They get the ball out of the centre like that. They got space, had a good look, good lead up by Darwin, and he's made no mistake there. Put it straight over the goal umpire's hat. So that centre clearance work, I think, is good focus for them. If they can break Cable Beach's run and maybe pinch a few themselves, they can claw back in.
Ball back in the middle. Ready to go again as the wind picks up here at Haynes Oval. Torrey Cox, Carriman doing the ruck work. Clearance not done just as hard. Cox goes in hard here for Cable Beach, trying to get it out. Tip, tap, tappity, tap we go. And here go Peninsula. This would be great if they could get two in a minute. Going backwards to go forward. In trouble is Alfonso. Alphonse Cox
just
got pinged in the end.
Tackle just lingered.
Bit of chatter going on there with Sev Corpus as well. But Peninsula comes again. Here they go, Brett Dan. Great tackle. Holding the man.
Just a few tackles there from Cable Beach. Maybe their frustration, they're a bit fatigued from running forward.
Corpus chips it across. And Peninsula starting to build just a little bit of momentum. Tyson Cox it is. Chips it on inboard, but it is a picked off by Joe Dan, who's been brilliant off half-back today. And away they go through the sprightly number 33 and Chris Oakley. Here they go, Cable Beach. Easy as you like. Doesn't hit the target. Well, watch out for Eddie. What can Eddie McGinty do? He gets tackled away. The ball heads out of bounds. Will be thrown in.
Probably the first one they've missed going inside 50 on that side, Ed. Cable Beach have really hit their targets there. And that one just a little over the leading forward's head. But got the throw in. See if they can snag one back.
Danger zone. Horseman doing the ruck work. Tapped across again. Eddie McGinty! For a behind.
It's always excitement when he's around, isn't it? He just snared that. Before you could blink, it was on the boot. And before our roof blows off.
I see you battening down the hatches. Dylan Snorer had to hold it the whole time while he was commentating in the women's game. It is breezy here at Haynes Oval today.
It's blown the footy away as well, so we've got a little reprieve while we set back up here. But
we're a bit worried here. The Cable Beach mob are laughing at us. Our tent's about to fly away. Mary Poppins style.
They come prepared. They've got no shade over them.
Howard, deep in the back pocket, wants to play on quickly and create, as he always does. Oh, good tassel there by Nathaniel Hale, who's been good today.
Just
and a free kick against him for laying the tackle. And away they go.
Chance here. If he can.
Under pressure.
Bit of overlap run there from Cox.
Trying to get something out of it, but they've run out of time yet again. Peninsula do have a major on the board, though. 1-2-8 they are, but they trail dramatically. 9-7-61. It is halftime here at Haynes Oval. Cable Beach in complete control. The wind doing a little bit of troubles for us as well, but what we have seen is high-flying marking, big long kicking goals and some exciting footy, and we hope you're enjoying the coverage here on Galari. WKFL Men's Division round four footy, I should say. It is Cable Beach in control against the Bombers. 61 plays 8. Ed Cowlishaw and Tom Chapman in commentary. What do you think about that one, Tom?
Look, Cable Beach's foot skills really just open them up there. Moving the ball from, even when the Bombers managed to get it close to their forward 50, which was not that often, to be honest, Cable Beach just rebounded so well. They open it up, changed across from way from the broadcast end, unfortunately. So we're not seeing close up those great foot skills, but they're just opening it up, using the breeze to come back in and making it look like a bit of a train drill up there in the forward 50. The forwards are marking up and then just kicking the goals.
And we've seen what Peninsula can do. We saw what Din Hunter did before. Got the clearance, had the poise. This is why he's the leader of the side as well. Good use of the ball, make smart decisions, hit the lead up target, and Boston Digwan kicked the goal. It happened brilliantly. They need more of it though. They need to win those clearances, and this is where Cable Beach have really been dominating. They get those quick clearances, and you've got key forwards like Roman, who's got 3 goals. Kiefer Yu with 2 as well. Horseman's been proactive. And also the likes of Eddie McGinty, who's been a live wire forward, just creating dangerous momentums. They're killing them on the turnover.
They're setting up really well behind, especially looking at how the Bombers are favouring this side with the win. They're trying to kick, get the distance on the win, come out the broadcast side. Cable Beach are just waiting for it. It's hitting the wall and bouncing back with interest.
We're going to take a break for halftime. We'll be back shortly with the second half. Cable Beach in control, 61 plays 8. Good on you, Jolly, and we're here at Haynes Oval, of course. Nice to have a yarn with you wherever you are around the Kimberley and wherever you are listening or watching this broadcast today. Of course, each Thursday you can catch the broadcast of this game in particular on GTV on the replay there. Eric Cowlishaw and Tom Chapman in commentary. Can Peninsula come back, Tom?
Well, I think there's chance for it. You see when they get the ball out of the middle, Ed, they can run forward, hit up the leading target. That's how they scored their goal. It took one. If they can stop Cable Beach's run from the middle, those centre clearance dominance that they've got, I think they can claw back into it and, you know, let's make a good game of it.
Well, let's hope so anyway. Commanding position at Cable Beach, 9-7-61 to 1-2-8 as we're about to get underway for the third quarter. Going up there that time was Hale for Cable Beach. He ends up on the bottom of the complete pack, and Peninsula go forward here. Great mark. Beautiful mark, Joey Dan. He's been great on the back line today, setting things up here with Stephen Howard, and away go Cable Beach along the broadcast wing. A long kick up and away. Trying to get into the action there is Davey. And good work there by Leach to move it on forward. Howard, stab kick Elijah. Trying to find Maher, doesn't end up hitting the target. It's you, in fact. And now they try and get themselves out of trouble, but Howard wraps up Cox. And the Cable Beach boys are happy here on the boundary line as they're going about their business.
There's a solid tackle there put in by Howard, and he's locked the ball in there for the Beach.
So ball up, 60 metres out from Cable Beach's goal. You, high up and under kick. The wind's taken that one out of bounds on the full. And it will be a free kick going to Jaden Howard.
See if the Bombers here can try and break this zone that Cable Beach is setting up and get it out of their defensive 50. It's key for them to get back into this game, really, Ed.
How is he going to create? Long kick to the centre square and Hale, big mark. Starting to become a presence in this game is Hale. Already got a goal to his name. Chips it across the mark. Great setup there by the big man. Setting up his key forward for number four today.
It's good composure from Hale, wasn't it? He didn't rush it. He what a shape to have a kick. We all knew it was beyond his range and just popped it into the space there beautifully. Forwards to run onto.
So Romar, no pulling of the socks up for him, the number 31. Got three next to his name. Can he add a fourth? Really tough breeze to kick into. Nice deliberate style. Pops it up straight as an arrow for a behind. The breeze just capturing that as it went through.
Yeah, just couldn't quite sail it back there. Went straight, was waiting for the wind to push it, but couldn't quite bring it through for a major. Again, the Bombers here trying to get it out. They break on this side.
Oh, had to work hard there. Was Cox, Tyson that is. He's under the pump. And Howard has been rewarded for his tackle. Great effort there by the big man.
It's two in a couple of minutes for Howard. He's really come out firing here at the start of the second half. And I think he'll take his shot here, Ed, I believe.
And Cox has been on the recipient of both of those tackles as well, the big man. Look at him strapped back as well. Got some confidence, the number 29. There's no doubt about that.
I don't think we'll see a short pass here, Ed, and see if he can work it back with the breeze through the goalpost.
Just having a look at the breeze as well. Which direction is it going? Swirling around. He creates an arc on it. Whoa. And looks to centre the kick, I think he does. Up it goes. Ma at the fall of it. Oakley! Great work there by Christopher Oakley for his first of the day. 10-8, 68 to 1-2-8.
And that's what you want from your small forwards, isn't it, Ed? Just read it off there. I think you're being generous to say that Howard was putting that up for a square at the top of the square.
Wasn't everyone centering it today? The wind?
I think the kick might have sprayed or he allowed a bit too much for the wind, whichever way. But Oakley's come through and just bread and butter that. Took it off the hands, front and square, and that's what you want your small forwards. Drill home the goal.
So first major for this quarter for Cable Beach. In front by 60 points. 10 straight goals. What can they mount out of it this time round? Corpus creating something out of nothing in the middle of the ground. Jaden Howard's going to have to do something here for the Bombers. He may end up with it. Oh, there's the recent goal kicker there in Oakley. Got his legs taken out from him. Still back up. Snaps across his body. But to no avail. And Tyson Cox, who has been in the thick of the action, chips it across. But Eddie McGinty's at the fall of this. Has support if he needs it. They work with each other. Beautiful work there by Stephen Howard. Gets it off to Elijah. Stephen may end up back with it. And a free kick.
Good
going away to Elijah Howard.
Bit going on after the follow-up there, but just a good delivery in, and Howard didn't make any mistake with that. Held on to it. Got his arms chopped. Might be someone down there in the pocket just after play.
Looks like a shoulder injury as well. So umpire's just holding things up a little bit. Just seeing who it is.
It's Stephen Howard might be down.
So
clutching the shoulder there, looks in a bit of grief.
Not happy with that.
Doesn't seem to be too much carry on though, so it might have just been in the follow up after that. After the ball spilled, there was a tackle. He does look a bit ginger coming off, doesn't he?
Always watching Seb Corpus as well, just here on the bench, just as he's taking names, as they come up on who injures his players and lets them know a bit of sledging going on as well from the bench. Just making his way off the ground as well, in a bit of pain, is young Howard. Meanwhile, Elijah Howard, hemmed in on the boundary line.
See if he can make a better fist of this one with his left foot.
I think it'll be another centering kick, personally.
I think he's seeking redemption here. He's going to wheel around. Put this one through, Ed.
Just creates a little bit more arc. Stabs at it. And look at the way the wind treated that one with disrespect. Through for a behind.
Battered it away from the goal face, didn't it? It was on target. I thought he was going to prove me right. But
so he's gone. He's gone left. He's gone right. Next one might go through the middle. We'll have to see. Stephen Howard just feeling a little bit of a stinger in the shoulder at the moment.
Bit of grass on the shoulder too. Took a bit of turf on the way down.
So Cox kicks it out. Eddie goes up for it. Doesn't get it, McKinty. Willie Farrer off to Hargenor. Starting to link up nicely here, Peninsula. Nice work again. Cox, Alphonse. Nice marking attempt there by Jugwan. That's Boston. Play on quickly. Here's a chance here for Peninsula. Punched away by Dan for a behind. Great defence, Cable Beach. They were under the pump.
That was a great passage of play there by the Bombers, though, Ed. They really moved the ball quickly, and you can see that's their best opportunity, I think, to open the beach up.
139 plays 10-9, 10-9, 69.
Got the intercept mark.
60-point margin, but maybe a 7-point play coming up here for the Bombers.
Seen some good shots from out that side, Ed, so...
Little chip kick here by Harwood. Doesn't find the target. It's chipped off in the end. And Homan marks it in defence. Looking for options. Trying to set something up. Horseman under the pump. Nice mark taken there by Jaden Howard. Is he going to be paid? No. Yes. Wait there. Hate to run between wickets there. Howard. Little stab kick. Finds the target.
It's better from the Bombers there. They just kept their composure. Got the intercept mark on just outside their 50, and coming in, he's really lowered the eyes there, which is what you want to see. Leading forward. Needs to do his job here and put one through for the Bombers.
Boston Duguan, the only goal kicker for the Bombers today. Can he slot through his second? Pops it up. Not enough carry on it. Up go the marking attempts, and off hands and through for another behind.
Try and lock it in here, the Bombers, and get a few repeat 50s and hopefully score their second goal.
So looking for opportunities as the wind starts to pick up again here at Haynes Oval today. A lot of work going on behind the scenes to just keep our marquees up. This is just painting a picture of what's going on behind the footy action for you as well. Cable Beach, slow and deliberate in their build-up in this third quarter. Nice talking out there in centre wing as well as they start to build again. Ma up from full forward. Tyrone Cox under the pump, twisting and turning. Also there is Alphonse. Alphonse gets the handball away. Free kick back out to the Bombers. For legged, tripping.
Legged, and he's given 50 as well here, Ed. I'm not sure what's going on there. Might have been a few words.
Well, didn't get the ball back in time, I would think.
This is a chance here that the Bombers need. They come about by 50, but they can push the ball inside their own 50 here, hopefully, and create something, because they really do need to score their second major to get back into this game, Ed.
So now into the middle of the ground. They were on half back. What could the Bombers muster off this? Looking for options.
There's a little bit going on in the middle of the ground there too, Ed.
Corpus skiing into Din as well. There's a bit going on. When it comes to Sevi Corpus, he wants to say g'day to everyone as the play continues on.
Got the mark there just in the forward pocket while a bit of action was going on outside the 50.
So Courtney Cox to put the second major on the board for the Bombers today. Nice looking kick. Another major on the board for Peninsula.
That's a good shot there. It was tough. The wind was really blowing, and for the left footer, he did well to jail that without pushing it right over the face. But just good play there by the Bombers. They kept the ball inside their forward half. Intercept marks. Didn't allow Beach to run around that open side, which they've been doing with such success so far this game. So hopefully the Bombers can keep that going, string a few together, and get right back into this match.
2-3-15 plays 10-10-70. Cable Beach leading Peninsula Bombers here today. WKFL footy action, Ed Calishore and Tom Chapman in commentary with you for round four action of the men's division. 6-6 and sixes, just matching that up. As Jordan King's just waltzing along, and a free kick just not there in time. He's not happy about it, Jordan. And his opposite number will play on quickly.
Bombers with a bit of a surge here. If they can nab one or two, Ed, you know, a bit of a run on. That's what they need. The spark might come.
Solomon Pomora.
Barrel.
High up and under barrel to the goal square. Play out quickly. Bang, goal!
Darwin. Great mark there. Just read the flight there. The Torp coming in. Surprised the defence, I think, Ed, and carried that little bit extra. Penetrated through the breeze. It was a great barrel. We'd love to see that, don't you?
Two in a minute for the Bombers as they march their way back into this game. Only just. And it is 3-3-21 to 10-10-70. And that time there, it was Barber Dewan getting the goal. Nice effort. And wow, maybe they might get a roll on. Bit of momentum.
Oh, look, that's what they need there. If they can get another clearance or two, Ed, they've really dried up for the beach here. They're not running forward out of the centre, so Bombers could be back in this. You never know.
Trying to tap it down there is Hale. Clearance is important here for Cable Beach. But away goes Jaden Howard again. Slaps it on his body in the Hargenor direction. He stayed down as Cable Beach went up. Trying to get a quick kick away out of bounds on the full. No, just beforehand. Trying to protect. Tom, you might get a free kick here. Ball in play.
Didn't quite float out on the full there, but
Jaden watches the bike brilliantly, which is great. Like that.
Umpire's generous. Seen those paid for deliberate in other times, but going to get the throw up here.
It's a ball right on our broadcast wing. Chapman now has a touch, which is great. Hargenor trying to get out of trouble. Needed support. Great tackle by Cable Beach. And away they go again. Kept him
alive.
Really good work.
Oh, and a strong
Hunter.
Tackle. That is a sensational tackle.
And, well, Willie Farrer decided to state his claim for tackle of the year. Oh, look at the wind hold that ball up. Really went sideways in the end. No penetration on that kick whatsoever from Willie. They're going backwards, they go forwards. Here they go, and Willie's going to end up with it again. This time there's a little bit of air in it. So Willie Farrer looking for options. Got nothing down the line, so he chips it across to Din. Din in trouble. Back to Willie. They're under the pump, and he had nothing to kick to. And Sev is up and about as well. The hard man, he's having a chat there to Din. Having a good little yarn with one another.
Might be feeling that little bit of pressure coming from the Bombers here. Kicked a few in a row, and Beach not used to that coming back on them.
Tap down, putting second thoughts. Din didn't have the ball, played for the free kick, but also got it as well. Horseman, and still a little bit of food, a bit of feeling in this one. Din Hunter saying good day to one another. Not getting too sucked in. Look at the ball just go backwards and drift. Love that with my off spinners. Jaden Howard. Great tackle again by Oakley. Will there be a free kick? No, just all wrapped up.
This is a Bombers' chance here. They've got a bit of momentum, Ed. They need to capitalise. They're playing well, holding up well in their defence. If they can jag another one or two, I reckon we could be in for a good final to this.
Up they go. No one really laying a hand on things that time. Cox tried to get his hands on it. The other Cox for Cable Beach moves it on forward. That was Daniel trying to get an option going forward. But here comes Willie Farrow again. His handball going backwards as well, floating in the breeze. Howard, this time trying to go forward. Finds the target there in Alphonse Cox. So Alphonse plays on quickly. Nice long kick, trying to use the breeze as best they can. A hellish chaos ball played on quickly. This is a chance for the Bombers, as Tom Chapman's been saying. Nice little lace out kick. Can he find the lead? No, punched away. But here comes Horseman galloping away off half back.
Whee, and there's a crash. Let him know about it too after that kick.
Centre wing it is.
Downfield.
Downfield, and Hale will take this. No, it's Oakley in the end. So Christian chips it across and finds Yu. So Yu looking for options. Watch for Ma. Lead off the break. Seb's going to have a chance here. Corpus, the old man. He's been having a chat to everyone, and I reckon if he kicks this, he'll let everyone know about it as well.
I think we will hear from him if this goes through, Ed. But this would be a bit of a dagger for the Bombers because they've really dominated the last five or six minutes. Not being able to just claw it back enough. And if Beach go down and just jail this one, it's going to hurt them a bit, I think.
So Sevi Corfus lines up. And through for a behind. Boy, he would have told everyone for the next 3 weeks about that one.
Still feeling in this game, Ed. And I think the Bombers have shown there that if they get a run on, they can do some damage. But it's whether they leave it too late or if they can keep that going.
Cox looking for options. Hasn't been many of them. It's been valiant today. Down back and away they go. Starting to work forward here through Boston.
That's a great mark in traffic
nice
there.
Nice mark as well. Willie Farrow again. Classy player for the Bombers. Plays on quickly. Looking for options in Cox. That's Silas. Goes inboard. Jaden Howen's got a bit of work. He loses his feet on it. Everyone falls over. And here comes Oakley. Look at the speed. Hand passes out. Finds Jackson Leach. Back to Oakley. Took his head off. Double. And they're getting lazy here. Cable Beach can't get sucked in. They don't. But they're not happy about it.
Feeling there, he might have done a bit of a Joel Selwood. But
and downfield as well. Losing discipline, and here we go. Bit of chatter going on as well.
Your man coming to the bench, Ed.
So you, from outside 50, the wind will be against him. Looking for another major. Look at it, take away in the breeze. Through for a behind, swings far right, and another behind on the board.
So you got a lot of purchase on that, didn't he? But the wind really just swayed it off. Tough going there. But, yeah, clamps have been turned back on the Bombers here. If they can't get this ball outside of their defensive 50, feel that the beach might just break them, Ed.
So Cox looking for opportunities. Chips it across. Finds the target in Michael Dragoon.
This next kick's been the problem, really. They get stuck here. Beach is set up really well on this side.
Goes to the fat side of the ground. Jaguin. Goes inboard. Up we go. Free kick given away there by Keelan Davey. He's seen what his teammate Eddie McGinty's been doing. And I got told earlier that McGinty took mark of the year the week before. It took a better mark than what we saw earlier today. Goodness.
I'm sad we've missed it and the cameras weren't on, Ed. That was a special mark.
It was a very special mark, wasn't it? Nice build-up happening now through Simone Cox. And this is what they want, Peninsula. All bit of cramp going on. Tyrone Cox has run a long way to be a part of this. He may end up going off the ground, but chipped over to his opposite number in Carryman. Carryman, I should say.
Oh.
There's Eddie McGinty. He'll play on quickly. Under the pump. Kept his feet, which was important. Oh, a head clash there with the Bombers. They play on quickly. Going in hard again is Davey. Again, he might get Howard in the end. A nice mark taken there by Pomora. So Solly Pomora. Long penetrating kick up and away in the Dragoon direction. But again, it's the safe hands of defence by Joe Dan. Onto the outer side. What can they set up? Streaming through the middle of the ground is Cable Beach through you, trying to find a target off hands of Ma. They still might get away with this, Cable Beach. Holding the ball, got twisted around in the 360 momentum.
It's really an arm wrestle at the moment, Ed, isn't it? Who's going to kick that next goal? Could break the game up.
40 seconds to go in this quarter. Here comes Leach. Broadcast wing, Oakley, slowing things up. Cable Beach still a chance. Oh, pinpoints the opposition there in Oakley and finds Dragoon.
They need
into
one here,
the middle
the
of the ground. Still an option as well. But here comes Cable Beach. If they're good enough, they may get one before three-quarter time. Cox chips it across. Paddock to play with. Yu could take a bounce. Steadies himself. Goal, goal, goal!
That's a really crushing goal there. For the Bombers, they'd put so much effort there, spent a lot of their petrol tickets trying to get back in that game, Ed, and Beach just held on. They resisted, and for that, look, it's only going to get the siren now. That's really got to be a dispiriting one by Kiefer Yu at the end there.
Kiefer Yu with another major on the board. He's now got three for the game, and that was a brilliant running goal from half back. In fact, that's where he's been positioned for this latter stages of this quarter. And just really good work. Another 6-6-6. They're hot on this. Really hot on this, the umpires. This is up to the players to all be in control of it. Wouldn't be long to go in this quarter. So chip it across. Cable Beach may get another one if they get a marking opportunity. Ma loses a handle on it that time.
Oh, spins trying to out push of trouble it on nicely. Forward.
Good chance there by Leach. There's Ma. Still in play. And misses the opportunity in the end, Cable Beach. But it's three-quarter time. 11-12-78 to 3-3-21. Cable Beach in control, but we did see a couple of goals in a minute and a bit, which was really exciting for Peninsula. But again, undisciplined acts letting him down, Tom.
Yeah, that controlled aggression. We spoke about it around quarter time. They came out bustling. They had a lot of energy, the Bombers, but just a little bit misdirected, a little bit. Now, the intention was there. You can't fault the effort. But, yeah, they didn't capitalise. And you see what they can do when they get a run on there. A couple of goals in a minute. Had some great passages of play. Felt there, though, Beach just held it off, didn't they? They held it off, controlled the ball back, and they're sitting pretty.
In complete control. They did have a run on of five behinds in that quarter, Cable Beach, if they had a kick straight. But the wind was not letting them. Mother Nature is just wielding her wand today. There's no doubt about that. But the bonus is they will have the ascendancy of somewhat of a breeze in that last quarter. We'll see what damage can be done from both sides. We'll take a short break, final quarter of this matchup of the round four clash, WKFL Men's Division, Cable Beach leading the Bombers. Yeah, you are with Ed Cowlisher and Tom Chapman here. About to go into the last quarter of this Men's Division Clash Round 4 games here in the WKFL at Haynes Oval today. It's Cable Beach versus the Peninsula Bombers, and Cable Beach in complete control. 11-12-78 to 3-3-21. It's been slim pickings for Peninsula, but they did kick a couple quickly in that third quarter. About to get underway, waiting for the six six and sixes, making sure everyone's set up, umpires on the ball. They're not moving until everyone is in position and ready to go as we get underway for this last quarter. Cable Beach in control. Peninsula can do some damage if they get some clearance work going. But this time it is Cox, Daniel Cox, with another clearance for Cable Beach. Big opportunity here. Elijah Howard's been a power at centre-half forward. They play on quickly. Here comes McGinty. Snaps across his left looking for an opportunity. A great work there by Tyrone Cox for the Bombers to clear it away. Jaden Howard losing a hand on things. Great tackle. Not high. No, it's a free kick. Great tackle.
Done well there not to get in his back, I think. And just that pressure bringing it, aren't they? Cable Beach, they're not letting up.
So Keelan Davey putting on some good forward pressure and a great opportunity. Excuse me. Jordan King. It is.
We've seen Cable Beach kick goals from this side, Ed, so I wouldn't be surprised if he slots this one.
No, it is Keelan Davey. Pardon me. Just moving across the face of goal and through for a behind.
Again, McGinty sailed, didn't he? Just gets up in that wind and gets that leverage. Beautiful to watch.
So Peninsula, can they create something off the back line? Struggled to get any scoring opportunity from defence today. Oakley actually goes up. Really had no one to fly with, and he's hit the ground pretty hard.
Certainly went up and he came down pretty tough as well there, Ed. I think he's
winded himself quite badly. Ball comes out to the broadcast wing. Harjanor had the first scoring opportunity for Peninsula today and then been quiet ever since. And beautifully read there by the number 15.
Like he's moving Malay. Around
the right. So Malay. Gosh, they're working hard. Players starting to fall down left, right and centre. Joe Dan hitting the dirt there. Hale onto the outer side. Finding Jordan King. I'm just trying to work out where the ball is actually going to be taken.
There was a late hit there just after he kicked the transition switch, and I think they've paid a 50. It's moving up to the centre of the ground now. Ed.
Nearly had full completion of circle work there. Chips it across. Cox. Looking for leads, left, right and centre. Plenty on offer. Misses all of them. Over the top. Here comes Ma. Smart work. Snaps on the right. Bang goal. That's how it's done, lads.
very nifty there again. That's the second time he's just been front and square. And that's what you want. Small forwards, drop of the ball. Picked that up and made no mistake there. Very crafty turn onto his right boot, wasn't it?
Great goal there by Romar. He's kicked four for the day. Peppered in the third quarter. But may end up with a big bag.
Yeah, look, don't want to see this get out of hand if you're a Bombers fan, do you? Because like, final quarter, Cable Beach, we know they can score quickly when they run that centre clearance dominance. So Bombers need to hold on here, I think, Ed.
12-13, 85 to 3-3, 21. Sting's gone out of this one. There have been flashes of brilliance from the Bombers, but Cable Beach in control for most of the day. Another good tackle, ball to be thrown up in the middle of the ground. Wind has been keeping us company all day long if you've just joined us on the broadcast. Been quite intense in a lot of ways, on and off the field. Good tackle. Parriman getting the free kick, that's Dion. Dion chips it across, and away goes Joe Dan. What can he set up from the middle of the ground? Looking for the lead, doesn't find Ma. Well read there by Willie Farrer. He scampers off. Again going lateral, trying to find an opportunity there for Cox. Free kick again. Going the way of Cable Beach. Dan chips it across for an opportunity. Here's Ma. One step. Beautiful lead out. Beautiful mark. And you, Kiefer that is, will have a chance to kick his fourth for the day. He chips it across. The selflessness of Cable Beach setting up players left, right and centre.
He's marginally improved the angle there, just giving someone else a shot at goal, I think, Ed.
So William Hunter it is. For his first major today and to the add to the scoreline. May the umpire work. Through for a behind.
I think the wind saved the Bombers a bit here. That scoreline now with 26 scoring shots. Could have been a lot worse reading for the Bombers.
So the question is, will their heads completely drop? Or will they keep the fight up to Cable Beach for the rest of this quarter? 5 minutes gone. Wind picking up. Cox with another torpedo. Bit of a mongrel punt in the end. But ends up in safe hands through Howard. Onto the outer side. Trying to create his Howard. That's what he does. But Cable Beach intercept. And away they go. Into the middle. And beautiful lace out kick.
It's really been a
problem Oakley.
In their back 50. Getting picked apart there by Cable Beach coming in just too many times. Too many shots at goal. This would be the 27th scoring shot you'd imagine if they even register a behind. But need to tidy that up, the Bombers, or this could get really ugly.
Well, here's the man to do the damage. Romar got four next to his name. Outside, just inside 50, he'll kick it. Good looking kick. Look at the spiral on that. Pops it up. But again, the wind wreaking havoc. For another behind.
There's still things to take away, I think, Ed, from this for the Bombers. They need to work on breaking out of that defensive 50. Getting bogged down, and partly due to Cable Beach's pressure, but need to work out a way to get it through.
Well, they have the capability to heat up marks, but it's those centre wing marks and that third kick which lets them down. And here's an attacking player in Jaden Howard, who loves to create off halfback. That's why he's there. He needs this mark to work. And players have hit the deck. Cramps starting to filter in. But here come the Bombers again. But Cable Peach say no. That time through Davey. High up and under kick. Now inside the forward 50 again. Look, a big hail run. Lovely work. Homan there as well. Back to Cox. Cox, did he set something up? Misjudges the kick entirely. And Solomon Pomora.
Had to come a fair way up to get that mark, hasn't he? You've seen him up forward in the 50, but
Pomora onto centre wing. Hey. Up they go through Cox. Doesn't get it. Cox again, working hard. That's Daniel for Cable Beach. And Homan just sees it over the boundary line and it will be thrown up.
Still some excitement about for the Bombers there, launching themselves. You see the forwards, they haven't had much to do, but they're throwing at it when they get a chance here. Want to see him try and run it out strong, don't we, Ed?
Horseman in the thick of it. Watch for him to get the ball off the break. Cox, head over the ball. Got collected there by Pomora. Ball out of bounds and greets the umpire's tent. So Horseman will take the free kick. Chips it across, misjudges it. The wind carrying it there. Oh, somehow protected the ball there was Jordan King. Got himself out of trouble. High up and under kick, and where has it fallen? Right in the lap of you-know-who, Ed McGinty.
Didn't need a launch for that one,
did he? No, he didn't. He stayed grounded.
Just took a chest mark there. I was actually waiting for him to jump over someone's head, but it...
Oh, where's he kicked out? Tried to use the wind. Who knows what's happened there, but it's out of bounds on the full.
Maybe he had a bit too much spring still in his legs, so not having a sore for it.
So Brett Dan for Peninsula's just gone there, mate.
Well, look, you can't do everything. He's played pretty well, McGinty, taking a specky, kicked a few snags, but that one, he won't want to watch the highlight of that one.
So Cox looks for options, chips it across, finds Howard, trying to create off the back line, not too far, far enough. Under the pump, here are the Bombers, trying to get themselves out of trouble by handballing. Here comes Din, free kick, advantage paid. Kicks it out of bounds on the full. Yes, no?
And that's the water boy there calling that out on the full. The ump's called the ball up, Ed.
Yeah, I thought it just touched the line.
Whole ball over the whole line. They've escaped there, though. That's where they're really breaking down, as you said, Ed, that third kick coming out.
Tap down again by Parryman. Holding the man, free kick. Horseman will take it. Chips it across. Fall the ball, not great. Good effort there by Hunter. Playing on quickly. Nice, that pass by you. Use the ball well, and Mar's going to line up for number 5.
Well, credit to the Bombers. They're not giving up, Ed. You still see some intensity there, but Cable Beach have just relentless, aren't they? They've kept pushing. That ball hasn't come past our midline here. And again, another shot at goal for Cable Beach.
So Romar for goal number 5. Good looking kick, look at the wind, take it still, but it's through the middle as it starts to drift. And that's number 5 for Romar today.
Looked pretty sure on that one, didn't he? Never looked like missing, just weighted it nicely, didn't try to kick it too hard. Used the breeze to just hold it in, and yeah, it's his fifth. It's a good game for him, isn't it?
13-15-93 to 3-3-21. Cable Beach in control. Romar's got 5 for the day, Kefa U with 3. And Edward McGinty with 2. Chief goal kickers up forward there for Cable Beach today. And a couple of singles there for the Bombers as well. Back in the middle, Parryman to do the ruck work. Willie Farrow as well. Tap down, trying to get it going. Something out of nothing. What can Din Hunter create? Harginor. Trying to find Solomon Pomora. But it's Oakley who gets himself out of trouble. He'll get the ball again, creating off half-back. Can't hit the target there in King. And here come the Bombers again, trying to create something. Alphonse Cox going forward. De Guine, this is a chance for the Bombers. Has they gone too far? Yes. Trying to do too much with it were the Bombers in the end.
Sold a bit of candy, but then he ran out, didn't he?
Dan, with poise, out of trouble they go. And Cable Beach, with cool heads, find Davey at centre wing on the outer side. Good lead-up play, Ma. At high centre half forward, in the back, free kick going his way, the key forward. Long way from home, not so much anymore as the free kick has been given away for a bit of bad language.
Yeah, that discipline coming back to bite the Bombers there. Just a bit of a scrappy free kick, fell in his back. Obviously wasn't pleased and said something that he shouldn't have to the umpire. But
also know the player who's got the ball. He's got 5 majors on the board.
Be licking his lips, won't he? Having another shot here, 35 out.
Nice half a dozen. Could be coming the way of Romar. Wind just dragged that away, didn't it? Completely for a behind. Wowee.
I'm sure they feel sympathy for us with our shade blowing away, Ed, but the players there, you've got the wind just picked up immensely as he kicked that. Took it an extra 3 to 4 metres across the face of goal for a pint.
It's WKFL footy action at Cowlishaw, and Tom Chapman with you today here at Haynes Oval. Round 4 of action, Cable Beach and the Peninsula Bombers going toe-to-toe. Leach wrapping up the tackle, going in high, says the umpire. And a free kick going the way of the Bombers.
Again, Beach just set up really well back here.
So another errant kick, and here they go again. Dan and King have been setting things up from the back line. Starting to build again, another little chip kick. This is deliberate play. Horseman, we can see what he can do off one leg. What can you do? He snaps it across his body and through as the goal umpire just did a little head check on it. And another goal is signalled.
Making it look a bit too easy at times there, Cable Beach, when they're getting it inside 50. And, you know, Kefiu doesn't need too much of a sniff. He's just took a step there, had space. Put it pretty much straight through the over the umpire's hat, as you called, Ed.
4 goals for Kefiu, 5 for Romar, the chief goal kickers. Up forward today for Cable Beach, 14-16, 100 to 3-3-21. No score registered in this final quarter for Peninsula.
Joe Dan comes off for a spell there.
He's been scintillating off halfback today. Good chance here by Leach. Needs someone to help out. Finds King. And away they go. Ooh. Horseman runs into trouble. Play on Harjinor. This is the chance. Harjinor lines up from outside 50. Rotating through for a behind.
Electric run there, wasn't it? He just got the carry. They got a breakaway. And it would have been nice to finish that one with a goal for the Bombers.
3-4-22 now, the Bombers, to 14-16-100. Game out of contention now for the Bombers, but pride is always on the line. Leach just waited for it. Good work there by Jaden Howard, who's been great today. Again, always trying to create, he is. Lovely work there by Solomon Pomora. But again, the kick is errant, and it goes the way of Aidan Albert. Cox. Daniel for Cable Beach. Had a fair bit of it today.
Unmistakable too.
Horseman just slaps it on the boot. Jaden Howard in attendance. Good shepherd that he's laid. Willie Farrer needs support. Gets it. Now back to Solomon. Solomon Pomora just pops it high in the air. Anyone could call this one. And Jaden Howard wanted it the most. He gets it on his left. This is a nice build-up by the Bombers. Dwayne Hart. Big, long, penetrating kick. Need a mark. Anyone want it? Hits the ground. Dwayne just puts the chainsaw effect on the ball. Goes up and down. Plenty of players around it. And the umpire says, hang on, I'll ball it up. 10 metres out from the goal.
Managed to lock it in there, the Bombers. Let's hope they can get a chance to score.
Tap down. Daniel Cox kicks it away. Bouncing, bouncing, bouncing. Leach won't get to it. And Mick Albert gets his first touch for the day.
Seen those called deliberate before, but I think the lack of crowd pressure, the noise of affirmation wasn't there for that one, Ed. Get the throw in.
16 minutes gone. Game pretty much done and dusted. But Jaden Howard just wants to keep on keeping on. May have hurt his leg quite badly with that one, with a smother on the kick. He's really limping badly. As Cable Beach move it to Kefa Yu. Yu, hand passes across. They play on quickly. Here comes King, looking to set up for Ma. Heads in the McGinty direction instead. He uses his turn of pace, takes one bounce, puts it on the right and says, thank you very much. We're done and dusted here today at Haynes.
Just electric, wasn't it? Just turned him inside out as we see Howard struggling to get off there. There's a stark contrast to goal at the other end there for the Beach. Just spun on a dime, blitzed away, and classy finish, wasn't it? Just snagged it on the left.
The turn of pace, how good was that?
I'm watching from here, envious, Ed.
Oh, so am I. My legs are hurting just thinking about it. Oh, great turn of pace there by Edwin McGinty. A highlight reel in the making, no doubt. 15-16, 106 to 3-4, 22. And again, opportunities gone begging in that forward half there for Peninsula. And Cable Beach make them pay off the turnover. Parryman again in the ruck. No hands on it. Hand passes over the top. King in the middle of the ground. Tackled. Bang goes Din. The captain of Peninsula, Din Hunter. Just laying a few more bruises for the rest of the game.
Give him one to remember as they go off with the victory there, Ed.
Parryman, quick kick away. Here come the Bombers with a clearance. But just strength personified there that time. They look to clear. In the middle of the ground is, off the half-back line, I should say. Centre-half-back, in fact, is Leach. Only a couple of minutes to go in this one. They clear. Centre it up again. Cox. Nice build-up off the half-back line. Methodical they are, Cable Beach, and the way they go about it. Leon Kelly. High up and under, helicopter kick it is. No one really in attendance, and a free kick. Play on advantage, easy mark as you like. And away they go, and here comes big Kefa Yu, trying to mark up number five today. What will he do with the win? Look at it come back, look at the curl on it. What a great goal by Kefa Yu. Someone's worked out the wind.
I tell you what, there's a... The helicopters are contentious at times here in Broomhead, but that helicopter worked a treat for him there. Just swung back through the goal. It's like a soccer corner kick, wasn't it?
Oh, it wasn't. It was absolutely sensational. Used the wind brilliantly, and he's got his fifth for the day. Levels up with Romar, five goals apiece, and another major on the board. 16-16, 112 to 3-4, 22. Only a matter of seconds left in this one here at Haynes today. Cable Beach taking the percentage with them as well and sitting pretty on top of the table. Might get another one the way that Jordan King's going about it. Horseman pops one high in the air. Peter Yu, Willie Farrer, jumped clear over his head, twist and turned out of trouble, popped it on his left. Harjanor trying to create something. Horseman goes in hard, free kick. That is the end of this one here at Haynes today. Cable Beach run out winners, 16-16, 112 to 3-4, 22. Goal kickers, Romar with five, Kefa Yu with five. And we had single goal kickers throughout the day as well. And three to Edward McGinty. And also Christopher Oakley chimed in with a couple as well. Nice to see Elijah Howard and also players such as the calibre of Hale getting goals today, but they just dominate from go to woe. Goal kickers for Peninsula today. Courtney Cox had one. Also, Barb Digwin with one goal there. And Boston Digwin also kicked one major for the day. But Cable Beach in control for pretty much the majority of it.
Yeah, they started it out really strong with the centre clearance work. Ed. They were dominating that first half entirely. Bombers, to their credit, slowed it up a bit. Got a few, you know, a bit of a run on themselves a couple of times, but the structures you can see from Cable Beach, they're going into 50, they clear out, they make space for each other, and you can see that in the spread of goal kickers there. 4, 5, 5, 3. You know, they've got so many avenues, and that's why they're sitting pretty up the top of the ladder.
Love the way out of defence that Joe Dan and Jaden Howard is trying to do for Peninsula as well. He got injured late in that piece there, but trying to create something out of that half-back line. But it's that second kick, third kick onto the centre wing where they're either not marking, and whether that's forwards not leading up and taking those marks. But when poise does come into the game and they do calm it down, Peninsula, they do have the capacity to go point to point, but it just falls down on centre wing.
Yeah, and you've got to put credit with that on Cable Beach. They're setting up so well. Joe Dan, you said, he's just running things off there, marshalling it around. And you feel for the Bombers. They were coming forward, trying to get forward to centre, and they're looking up at times, and all the space is blocked up there by Cable Beach. They don't have anywhere to kick. You know, the forwards are trying to work, they're trying to link, but it just comes back, and that's where Cable Beach are making them pay. Though, you know, you see there, 30 scoring shots odd. They really had control of that match.
Can anyone challenge them? Cable Beach. I mean, they are the benchmark this year and been really causing some headaches for a lot of sides. I know we're only early in the season, but they're really starting to flex their muscles early on in the piece. They're out by a lot, and well, there's a lot more work that needs to be going on.
Yeah, I think teams can disrupt them. We saw there, even for Patches, Bombers got their momentum. They broke down the centre clearance dominance of the Cable Beach side. And I think some of the teams that are a bit quicker at transitioning the ball, a bit quicker at running that overlap, Emus, Luma even to an extent, I reckon they can open them up, because when Cable Beach get their way, they set up there and they just dominate the ball forward of centre for themselves. You can't score if the ball's not going in your attacking 50 as the opposition, and breaking that line is I think the key to getting on top of them.
The Derby Tigers is another side that may challenge them early, and this is the thing. A lot of teams are going at Cable really, really hard. You see the frenetic pace, and this is Kimberley footy as it is, but they go toe-to-toe with them. They don't have that tactic of going, right, we'll go at our pace and let them dictate and do what they do. They try to challenge them at their own game, and it seems to be costly in a lot of ways.
It can. I mean, you've got to pick your strengths, and you know each team has their own nuances, their own style, but yeah, look, there's a reason that Cable Beach have been dominant for a number of years. They've been right up there all the time, haven't they? And taking them on at your own game and disrupting them from theirs, I think, is what you want to be, you know, what I'd be trying to get into the boys if I was coaching.
Well, Cable Beach stay undefeated today. They knock off the Peninsula Bombers quite comfortably. 16-16, 112 to 3-4, 22. Tom, great to have you in commentary today. Really enjoyed your company, and hopefully you enjoyed ours as well. WKFL footy round 4 done and dusted for us with our coverage. We'll be back next week with round 5. Hopefully you can join us then.